gotten the buff once on my character by clicking on this dude. Because our effigy is complete. So theoretically you should be able to just go in there and click on him and he gets you a 3-hour buff. But for some reason it isn't going to work. So we're gonna go into thing here. This is the instance. If you're chat, do say hi, because you know I don't bite much. And we're gonna see how this is gonna work. Mysterious portal. I'm gonna turn this off so I don't need them. Now let's go.
Jackshade's coming, sure as death, to lay you down and steal your breath. Put on your mask, hide with care, and pray the angel finds you there. Salvation's near, we'll carry on, but first survive until the dawn. Village lies just beyond the woods. I can sense a new evil, something horrible. You must make your way there.
All right, being a scientist, I can do this. Give me loot.
I'm helpless in the thicket, and it looks like you're having trouble too. For now, use your supplies to survive the darkness. Something scary lurks in the dark.
The shadelings.
But in a new form.
Be
careful. I'll talk to you soon.
The Chua animations. Some friends with Landmark are going to be playing some games, so that's kind of cool. Alright, eeny, meeny, miny, moe, let's go find. Alright, this is. Oh, hey, there's more stuff here. And anybody can open these if they glow. Oh, it's empty. How sad. And those blue haunts are really cool looking, but you don't want to run in them. And the Shades Eve event accidentally got shut off earlier today. And they turn it back on. Thank you, Carbine, for putting it back on there. Hello, you. Another one there. Come on, you. Come on. Oh, that just leads you into a trap? Now the thing about Shades Eve is, when you go into the instance, you don't always show up in the same place every single time. So sometimes you have to figure out how to get to the actual main part of the instance. In this case, go to this little town and jump through this little portal. And go to the actual town. About the haunts here, those blue things, those are the haunts. Oh, we get to watch me becoming the music here. This is awesome. Now about being a Shadeling is that you can only go so far before you can't go any further. See? They actually block you off from the maze, so you can't just run through the maze as a Shadeling and not, you know, deal with any damage. So, here's the, if you look at it, it's the Primal Echo. And the real me, as they say in, just ran past a Shadeling, which is kind of cool. Now, here, oh, and there's traps. As he was, once you go in here, you basically,
I'm feeling much better now, so I can help you out a bit. If you see my light, try to follow it.
Just speak some rhyme. And after a while, it'll actually put the little arrow on the mini-map, because at first you're on your own, like 3 or 4 minutes. But I've been through here often enough, I'm starting to learn the actual path.
Spy who can lead you onward, but be careful. You won't find many friendly people here.
At this point, I don't actually need my my bot anymore. My bot actually gets in the way, so I'll tell them that. And every time I run through this, I pick. You basically have two main options.
You survived the thicket. Impressive. It's impressive you found us here at Quiet Downs as well.
This is the sound of her voice kind of reminds me of June 4A.
The mayor must be told of your arrival.
And June 4A is like this 94, 95
year old woman. The preparations for our Shades Eve festival have begun.
We've been waiting for 100 years.
New blood like yours.
She's also known as being the voice of Granny.
The mayor is in the town square. He'll be so pleased you're joining us.
Her. There's a couple of times her voice actress sounds very much like June 4A.
A pass through the gate up ahead. Everyone contributes in Quiet Downs, you understand? Perhaps you too will be allowed to contribute.
Some other folks are streaming other stuff. Extra Life is coming up if you feel generous or feel the need to assist people. On my laptop, talk to my friend Katina, the mutual friend is going to be streaming something soon here. But in the meantime, I'm going to talk to the mayor.
And he told me that fresh blood had made its way into town. Luckily, you're just in time. We've been eagerly awaiting your arrival.
I'm curious to know who did the voice
Harlem
of the mayor.
Town throws a unique festival for Shades Eve. It's really to die for. So go on, take a stroll, meet some of the locals. I'll let you know when we're starting.
All right, so in this particular thing, you have two choices. You can either help the villagers, or you can choose to help this other lady, and I'll introduce you to her. Regular villagers.
The mayor told me there were visitors looking to help with our festival preparations. That must be you. Maybe you can play a key role in this year's ritual.
So you can either help them with their ritual. Doesn't sound too bad, right? Or you can talk to this other lady and find out what... You see these things, these are just, you know, they look like manifestations. manifestations of the angel, but they're not really. And over there, the red you saw, well, those are roused hours. Here, let's go check them out real quick. Including one that is pretty demonic looking. So, I don't know, they look kind of scary to me. Anyway, let's go talk to the other lady and find out what she thinks.
I've been sent to investigate this cult, so don't blow my cover. The mayor is crazy, and these people are not what they seem. You must help me.
So every time I go through, I pick one of the two options, and the next time I go through, I pick the other option. Last time I played, I helped her. So this time I'll help the villagers.
Have you had a chance to talk to Axius about setting up for tonight's event? Come to the town square and help us put up our decorations.
What a splendid idea. Pretend to help the mayor set up the ritual until we figure out what's really going on here. Be careful. He's a very bad man.
Dress up. So now my character looks like one of them, and we're gonna click on these little thingies. I don't know why, but I always like these little symbols that you click here. I'm not sure why they amuse me so much, but ever since I first saw them on the Dominion Ark ship, which I don't actually think you get to go to the place. Yeah, you don't get to see them, I don't think, anymore. When they revamped the Ark ships, they really removed a lot of content that was there, so people who were there don't really see it anymore. But the first place I ever saw these little targets was there. I don't know why I like this dude. For some reason, even they look like they're 3D, like they're a thin ring with the little footers on there, and then, you know, the little lights in the middle going to the center, but it looks like, off the top of, or the bottom of a can or something. Anyway, I don't, that's, because I guess the way they shape them makes it look a little bit 3D. Because see, this side is wider and that side's thinner. Yeah. Artistic lesson for the day. Alright, more things to put up. So, it's something of a non-secret, but I am arranging to go to Carbine. Not next week, but the week after. The Monday after BlizzCon, because I'll be in Southern California. I'll be talking to the devs about some stuff. That's assuming everything goes through. Right now, it's not 100% set in stone, but I've been there before. In fact, I was there last year.
What we need now is our guest of honor. We have quite the selection available in the barn. Perhaps you will select our special guest for us, hmm? Don't be shy.
No, last time you told me don't be shy, we were talking about actually playing Lord of the Rings online on a stream. And this is like an official stream. I'm like, really? Because I actually do get the... I'm fortunate enough that I stream crash Corey Olson, the Tolkien professor, in LOTRO. Let's see, Arathard is streaming. Let's see what he's streaming tonight. Probably Alien Isolation or something. Speaking of LOTRO, let me boot it up here real quick. I need to see if my friend Derek is playing on Arkenstone. Spoopy. Oh, he's gonna play Haunted Burrow. Haunted Burrow is fun. I do play multiple games. Right now I'm playing... Oh, Era's lady friend is... Mute them. And mute that too. Anyway, let's go pick somebody. We get a choice. If you look, there's people in here, and one of the bad guys. The other bad guys, the other bad guys. So, I could choose a Lop. Her name is Lena Bop. We also, Lop promised many, many shinies of Lop chosen to be guest of honor. Lop wants shiniest of Shade's Eve shinies. Please pick Lop, please! Let's see here. I didn't mean to hit that button. That's okay. No, my friend is not online. That's okay. Or we have a Draken, her name is Drevia. He says, I understand this is akin to the Bloodfire ritual, with less blood, of course. I'm very curious to see what humans do for this gathering. I'll be your guest. Whoops. What just happened? I guess she got picked. That's what I get for chatting. But you also have an RN and then a human Cassian. So, well, human, you're not sure if he's Cassian or Exile. Alright, let's go over here. They're partying. And of course, Drevia did not like that at all, so we're gonna go back here because this is what's happening. These two guys are kicking my damn ass. Alright, guys. Now, get out of the stupid. Take on it once. And I will reflect and die. Bad habit of.
Keep this up, and you'll wear out your death shroud.
On you, fools!
While we appreciate your help, we really must be killing you now.
Check Mumble real quick and see if a certain bunch of my friends are playing something, but I don't think they are. Yeah, they're in California, they're probably still doing trick-or-treaty stuff. Creepy. Now if you go help the villagers and defeat the person who, you know, is guarding this place, there'll be a dude here questioning whether you're here or not, or why you should be here. Check something out here real quick. I have to check stuffs out. Attention here, I'm gonna die. You'll all be amused at me. Dying.
This lab smells awful. There's so much suffering here.
That one is deliberately get too close to them, you will spawn a Shadeling to kill you. Help kill you. In the meantime, though, let me get this guy.
Most people hate dying, but you seem to have a knack for it. Clutch heals really have saved my bacon more than once, so... But it's very handy in that regard. Alright, now we're gonna smoosh this. And again, why are we breaking this? Because I would think that would make it start growing.
Thank you.
to not get your ass killed and generate a side point. So you also get interrupt armor for 5 seconds, which I find to be extremely helpful. It only works when you're in combat. And again, watch out for the shadelings over here and over here. Now they don't aggro unless you it's proximity. So I could like shoot a thing over here and it's not gonna aggro them. Again, these mini bosses also spawn a bit differently every single time.
Thank you.
of the burned orange you can find in Everstar Grove. Off to the side, you're one of the scientists.
The source of the disease is further inside. We need to stop these people before it's too late.
Your life story certainly is exciting. Of course, I know how it ends.
You know how it ends, really?
Yeah.
I'm reminded by Stan Sculpture that Peculia of Wowhead.com has tweeted half an hour ago, is don't be scared, fall back. It is in the United States. It is the end of daylight saving time. I have a cat, by the way. Yao has come to visit. Hi, Yao. I've played through this often enough. get to this without aggroing them. Big shiny sword, don't you? Alright, let's plan our mission here, kids. Let's take you guys out first. I don't wanna really aggro you guys. Get it in real life anymore. The problem is just that the design of the weapon is gonna prove interesting. And there's also the simple fact that I've never made a giant sword before. I think there's probably more to that.
Yeah.
How's everybody doing tonight? I hope you're having a good Halloween. And that was so bad, even the freaking Holocrypt didn't want to talk to me. That's pretty sad. One of the things is if you die repeatedly in here, you will take item damage. So, badly enough, you could not have any of your item buffs. Have to run this 12 times to get all the loot I wanted to get out of the
just beyond this door. I can sense his madness.
Alrighty.
He believes Jack Shade was real. He must be stopped.
What's really funny is if you trigger this door and then you die inside, when you come back to this point from the Holocrypt, it'll ask you to open this more door again. It recognizes that you do it the first time, the second time, and the third time.
No, you fools! You cannot stop us! Jack Shade will be reborn! First victim. So nice of you to join me.
That's the same effect that Druceri used.
Stop! I won't let you hurt anyone else.
Look how much HP
you must be the little brat who cured the plague so long ago. I'll deal with you too.
And he's also in the lead, so. Alright, let's go. Alright, you. Knock it down. Interrupting him is. Yeah.
Again? It's a pity we don't offer a bulk discount.
Set a trap. Run you.
Alrighty. Let's go! Run, 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 run! And I have yet to actually fall into one of these, though. There's